a surprisingly large number of freak hailstorms wreak havoc on shopping malls. And that's not a coincidence. Welcome to Minute Earth. Big malls, and their even bigger parking lots, are basically just giant slabs of concrete and asphalt that absorb the sun's energy and radiate that heat back out, which can raise the temperature at a mega mall by several degrees. That warm air rises, pushing up the topmost layer of the clouds, known as the tropopause. Meanwhile, the trees and grass that often border malls create shade and, through evaporative cooling, keep the surface temperature there cool, so the surrounding tropopause stays low and traps the rising air in a narrow column. As the column of air gets taller, the moisture in the clouds starts to condense, forming water droplets. At the same time, the volume of that column increases, creating a low-pressure vacuum effect that pulls air molecules towards the center, causing wind. In other words, it creates the perfect conditions for a storm to form. And the hotter the temperature on the ground, the quicker and higher the storm cloud rises into the frigid air above, increasing the likelihood that the water in it freezes into ice balls. The result? Concentrated destructive hailstorms focused directly over shopping malls. It's not just malls, of course. Any big difference in neighboring surface temperatures can trigger extreme weather. Megacities, known as heat islands, get up to 50% more rain than the tree-lined burbs. And sun-baked farm fields cut into the forest are way more likely to experience thunderstorms and tornadoes than the forests themselves. Luckily, through simple actions like planting trees in parking lots and sidewalks and farm fields for evaporative cooling, or even painting some of those areas white so they don't soak up as much heat, we can keep surface temperatures more uniform and limit destructive conditions from forming in the first place. Otherwise, there will be hail to pay. Trees and grasses aren't just good at cooling our microenvironments. They can also help keep our entire globe cool by sucking up planet-warming carbon dioxide. And now you too can help suck up carbon dioxide. With a little information about your habits and lifestyle, our sponsor Wren calculates your current carbon footprint and makes all sorts of suggestions about how to reduce it. Wren also allows you to offset the carbon that you do release by making a monthly contribution towards projects like this one, which turns wildfire-burned trees into natural crop fertilizer. And for each of the first 100 of you who sign up using the link in the description, Wren will plant 10 extra trees per person. That's pretty cool. Thanks, Wren.